As you support the New Life Evangelistic Center, you are literally helping save lives, restore souls, and doing so much good for all eternity. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. You are helping to save people's lives. You're helping give people a second chance. You're doing the very work that God has told all of us to do when He's told us over and over to shelter the homeless, feed the hungry, help the homeless. Yes, New Life Evangelistic Center, the last major walk-in shelter in mid-America, is doing that. And those of you supporting New Life Evangelistic Center are part of a life-changing work. I have with me a special guest at this time. Tell us your name.
Ivy Faulkner.
Ivy, how do you feel like New Life, by sheltering the homeless, is literally helping to save lives?
It's helping to save lives because they have things here that can help you. They save lives by keeping people off the streets. They feed them, they train them, and they try to help them, and they have them in prayer services, and that's really good.
Now, you know, we got enemies out there. We got a group that St. Louis Post-Dispatch wrote about. Group raises money here. And a group fighting to close the New Life Evangelistic Center Homeless Shelter Fund began crowdfunding on Tuesday. Neighbors in NLEC, led by developer Brad Waltrip, says they have spent over $160,000 in their multi-year effort to petition hearings against the shelter. But now the case is headed for federal trial. They say they need more money. The group was able to get the city to order an NLEC to scale back services or close, but a conclusion to the matter has been bogged down in the court system. A trial is set for next month. Well, please pray for this trial. How important is it that we battle these individuals? Think of it. They spent $160,000 to stop us from sheltering you and other homeless people. I mean, Wow. Talk about enemies. Talk about evil. Talk about people trying to come up with money just to stop the last major walk-in shelter. What's your take on that?
Well, I think it's not really good, but it's good here because when you come here, you're hurting, you're depressed, you have nowhere to go. So as far as them trying to shut it down, that's not good. That's not good because it should have it open for people who are willing to help themselves when they get here.
And if we had not fought these evil actions out here where they spend $160,000 and we are not engaged in these legal activities.
Right.
And we told you, well, we can't take you in. Where would you have gone? What would you have done?
Oh, I have no idea. I have no idea. I mean, I'm a problem to my family. I'm not really close to any loved ones. I have one older son, but we're not really close. So, you know, it would just be devastating for me.
Don't let it be devastating. Jesus says, come as you are. And you make it possible. You're literally saving lives. Put yourself in this lady's situation, in the situation of other women. How many women would be raped and robbed and killed out there on those streets? How many elderly men, homeless veterans, would be destroyed day by day as they've had to sleep outside as the weather gets colder? There's so many hurting people. And we have these individuals spending all this money that they could have been spending on to open another shelter if they didn't want them in their neighborhood and help bus them to that other shelter. But no, they just want to leave them out on the street. Leave them out on the street. We give you the alternative to do good, to do God's work, to get involved, to share a much-needed gift now with the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You're making a big difference in the lives of so many hurting people. Let's go to Ray.
Teresa Young is just joining our 30-day transitional program for the women. And Teresa, we're glad to have you with us here. And I understand you came to the shelter here at some point, and you're homeless.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about your background, how you became homeless, and how you found out about New Life.
Well, I've known about New Life for years now. Uh-huh. They helped me with my utility bills years ago. I basically came here from Cape Girardeau living with my sister and had no place to go. So here's where I wound up.
Mm-hmm. So so now, how has it helped you to be here at the shelter?
I've met a lot of really nice people that bend over backwards to help in any way they can. They're a lot nicer to me than sometimes family can be.
Mm-hmm. Well, we want to be a family in the Lord. That's what right. we want to be. So what are your plans now? Are you going to be looking for a job? Are you trying?
My plans are to seek employment and get a place of my own.
Uh-huh. And you're starting out with a 30-day transitional program. And while you're here, then, of course, we'll have you doing volunteer work here
yes.
with the shelter also. And then if you still need more than the 30 days, we have the option of doing the 90 days then, too. So.
Okay.
So have you started your duties here yet?
Yes, I have. Uh-huh. I work downstairs in the pre-store.
Okay.
And I like it.
And that is a very important thing. You know, all of these different ministries of New Life Evangelistic Center need people to run them. The pre-store, the shelter, you know, the
yes,
helping
sir.
In the lobby, a lot of different things like this. We need people to help. And we're glad that as we incorporate people into our 30-day program like yourself, and we have you help out, then too. We feel that that's all part of it. It's all very vital and important.
Plus, I intend to, once I start back to work and get my own place, still come back and volunteer.
Well, thank you.
Give back to the community.
That's important, too. We've had others, too, that have been helped through the shelter or with other forms of assistance, and then later come back and volunteer. And sometimes they make some of the best volunteers because they've been there, you know.
Exactly.
So God bless you, Teresa.
Thank you.
We welcome you here as part of our community.
Thank you.
Yes, there may be rich developers like Brad Waltrow, who's out here raising money to try to stop us from sheltering the homeless, whose family owns 23 properties in the area. We'd love to get his hands on this property. But you folks, we're resisting. Resist the devil and he'll flee from you. We're resisting in the name of Jesus. And we're able to do this because of those of you that are praying for New Life Evangelistic Center. So if we're prepared for trial November 9th, we're asking you to pray for us. We're asking you to stand steadfast with us. We're asking you to believe God with us for miracles at this particular time. And there are a lot of hurting people out there. You've seen them, haven't you?
Oh, yeah. I'm one of them.
Mm-hmm. And you see these mamas and these children that come in here day after day. Do you ever think about where would these mamas be staying at if it wasn't for this place?
This is a blessing. It really is. People don't realize how good and how blessed they have things that God has blessed them with, you know. And so it's very important not to use it or abuse it, but try to come in and help. And when you come in, pray and bring Christ with you.
Amen. Has it helped you draw closer to Jesus by being here?
Yes, yes. I mean, I have been hurting for a long time, Mr. Rice, and I've been through so much. And, you know, I never had Jesus in my life because I didn't think he heard me. But one day I decided to pray. That's all the strength I could do.
Yes.
And for some reason, my heart just got softened. My voice just stopped all this bickering and angerish toward people. And I just shut up. And I learned to read my Bible. And I learned to listen. And then I realized that God loves me.
Amen. How does it feel to know God loves you?
It feels good.
We got to pray that these people that are just so caught up in their bitterness and hostility and hatred toward the homeless, that they come to know that God loves them, don't they?
Yeah.
Got to pray for those that despitefully use us and persecute us, because, wow, it'd be easy to get, as we get older, bitter rather than better, right?
Right. That's right.
Well,
love conquers all.
Yes.
Yes.
And it's our love for the poor and the homeless, the fatherless, the widowed.
Yeah.
The veterans. That cause us to stand up against these principalities and powers and say, thus saith the Lord.
That's right.
I shall not be moved.
Amen.
I shall not be moved. And if we have to continue to keep going from trial to trial and court to court, I shall not be moved. Because I know what it would cost. It cost anywhere from $120,000 to $180,000 a month to put all the people, these people in hotels, in rooms at even $30 a night. And here we've spent, because we wanted to show the city and get permits, do everything safe, secure, $22,000 is what it's going to cost for the architectural, all the architectural work being done. They've done enough work to let us know that we could safely keep over 400 people in this big five-story building. And now we try to do all the things they want us to do and send our structural compliance engineer over to get permits, and they aren't letting those permits go through, you know, and saying that higher-ups are holding them back. Brothers and sisters, pray for those higher-ups. Pray for that mayor. pray not only for the city of St. Louis, but St. Louis County, which was out of its way to shut down and stop shelters from even opening over there. Illinois, please pray for Illinois, where we've seen shelter after shelter close in Granite City, Belleville, and other places. Pray for holy boldness to come upon local congregations that will hear what Jesus says and will do it, where a sanctuary truly is a sanctuary for people when they're hurting. They have a place to go, a place that they can come to, a place that our veterans who are willing to fight for our country, now it's our time to fight for them. And here's what I need you doing. I need you, number one, praying. I need you, number two, to get involved. Come on out and join us on the night with the angels. Come out and be a part of this miracle that on November 6th and get involved in the night with the angels. Call 314-881-3218. Starts at 6 o'clock. You say, what do you mean, angels? Hebrews 13:2, where Jesus tells us through the scriptures, we are told to entertain, provide hospitality for the stranger, for many have entertained angels unaware. Only God knows how many angels have stayed here. And here we have these developers, these condominium owners, spending $160,000 who will lock the angels out. Hebrews 1 tells us the angels are sent to minister to believers. And the one thing we're asked to do is give them a place to stay. Give them a place to stay. So many hurting and homeless people come, and many of them are veterans, and we're trying to help them. Not only 1411 Locust, but also our Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. Thank you for getting involved and letting God's light and love flow through you, each and every one of you that are sending those much-needed gifts now to New Life Evangelistic Center. P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. And just letting your light shine for the glory of God.
My name is Reverend Chris Rice, and I'm here with Tim. Tim, tell us a little bit about yourself and what brought you to NLEC.
Well, I'm a U.S. Army veteran, been out a few years. I recently got evicted from my home, and I needed a place to stay. And I've been to Larry Rice before, and they really helped me a lot. So I decided to come back and join the ministry in the 30-day program to try to uplift my spirits and keep my head focused and straight and just get some support.
Tell people a little bit about the atmosphere here. Do you feel that this is a positive place to stay and that it uplifts your spirit?
Yes, I do. It's a very positive place to stay, to seek the Lord and get some knowledge and uplift your spirit. Very much so.
What about the communion service that we just had?
Was very nice, and to honor the Lord Jesus Christ, and very nice.
Yeah. And so as you're staying here at the ministry, what sort of work do we engage you in? What sort of things do we have you do to help out here?
Well, we help feed the homeless, issue out clothes, and them sort of things.
Yeah. And so you're seeing people actually get help here at the ministry?
Yes, for sure.
Mm-hmm. And how does that make you feel? What does that do for your spirit as you're helping other people?
Well, it makes me feel good to see somebody reaching out, helping people that really need help.
How would you encourage someone else? There are many people out there who, you know, they work hard, but they feel like they just have very little in their lives to be grateful for. And here you are, you know, you're a veteran, you've served your country, and you might have reason to complain in your life, but you seem to instead have a different outlook. How would you encourage someone out there who doesn't know what to be thankful for?
Just don't give up and seek knowledge and wisdom. And spirituality is a very important part of that. And I'm still learning every day to work on learning my spirituality. And it's good to take a time out and just reflect on them type of things and just stay motivated and positive. Mm-hmm. Don't give up.
Yes, we must continue to keep 1411 Locust open to our veterans, keep our Veterans Coming Home Center open in Springfield, Missouri, and continue the many outreaches of the New Life Evangelistic Center. You make all that possible. How I thank God for those that are sharing. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. Ivy's joining me at this time, and Ivy, you indicated that this has helped you draw closer to Jesus by being here.
Yes, I realized that when I got here, I was kind of lonely and I was scared and I was a long way from home. My parents passed away. I had a brother that passed away. My children passed away, but one. So yes, Mr. Rice, I was very hurting.
How did you find out about this place?
Well, I had some people who had mentioned that they have a shelter here in St. Louis. I didn't know it was on Locust Street or anything like that. They just said that you can come to a shelter on Locust Street. And when I got here, I didn't know anything about anybody. I just knew that I was tired, and I was on the street, and I needed a place to sleep for the night. I was tired. So when I got here, they gave me some pamphlets and some books and told me about the shelter and what programs you have and the meals. And you know, they made me feel welcome. Yeah.
Ivy, what would you say to this man that's spent $160,000... and determined to try to get his hands on this property, shut us down, has this crowdfunding site set up, and just wants to fight tooth and nail. What would you say to that, Brad Waltrow?
I would say that he shouldn't do that. He should have a heart and learn to respect the fact that everybody can help each other like these big corporate businessmen do. You know, there are some people who are, you know, have to be in wheelchairs and who have to have assistance. And then there are just some people who will meet you halfway. They can do the work, but they need some assistance for you to help them do it.
They could have been spending this money on opening a shelter somewhere else if they wanted it.
Right.
But they don't. They just want to leave you and the others out on the street.
Right. But see, that's the devil. That's the devil. But like I said, he's, you know, he shouldn't think like that because there are some people who are really in need of a shelter.
And we're determined to continue to be there to help them.
Right.
So Cerinthia and her son Brandon came to the New Life Evangelistic Center. They didn't have any place at all to go. Ray's going to be talking to her in just a moment. There are so many women with children, so many broken people in our society. We shouldn't leave them out there to slowly die. We need to provide them help. And that's what New Life Evangelistic Center is determined to do. Go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and see all the programs, so many programs helping people in so many different ways. And it's all possible because of those of you that are directly sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center. New Life receives no city, state, or federal dollars, no United Way dollars. So it's your gift, your prayers, your involvement that make it possible for us to be there to help so many in need.
Cerinthia, you came to us homeless originally.
Yes, me, my son, my 20-year-old son, Brandon, we lost our house due to Section 8 because I couldn't pay my gas bill. Oh. And at the time, my son, Brandon, is a full-time college student in Forest Park. So I consider this, you know, a roof and a haven, giving him enough time to get finished with school so he'd be able to transcend, you know, getting his own place.
So he's been staying here too, huh?
Yes, he stays here too.
Okay. God. And so how have things been coming along for
you? Well, everything's been fine. You know, yeah, I really am thankful for, you know, the ministry because y'all have gave my son a lot of confidence. He's really growing. And even though we don't have a place, I tell him to be patient. It's God teaches us to be patient. You know how young folks are not patient. But I have learned a lot because I also come from a Baptist family. We believe in God. We study the Bible. So y'all have helped both of us a lot.
Well, it's so beautiful that you, as a mother, are able to impart this to your son and helping him to know the Lord and to know the ways of the Lord. That's so powerful and so important. In these days that we live in, you know, often there's not that kind of communication between the generations, you know, where they pass it along to the generation.
I also have a daughter, and I raise him, you know. I refuse to let the street and the world have them. So I've taught them early about God, you know, putting him first, you know, not being selfish or anything. But as they got older, then they have their own relationship with God. So I don't have to interfere. So
that's right.
They know better.
And I hope that this will be an encouragement to all people, all mothers and fathers that are out there. You might feel, I'm going through such terrible times. I can't bring my kids up right. But here's a lady that was homeless, was out on the streets, and she still is continuing to teach the ways of the Lord to her kids. And that's very important. I just want to commend you for that. I want to commend you. And so you've been with us now for about a month here.
Yes, I've been here for a month, and I worked 35 years as a CNA, so mm-hmm. now that I'm 50, I'm retired, you know, but I still, like I work at the free store downstairs, and mm-hmm. I encourage most of the women on the third floor, because when I first got here and went up to the floor, I always wonder why they frowned a lot. And I'm like, why don't you smile? Because God gives you breath every morning. You should be thankful that He's waking you up and that you can breathe. And now most of the women on third floor smile a lot. And I'm so glad for that.
I'm glad that you can be there to encourage them in that way.
Thank you. Thank you for praying for New Life Evangelistic Center. Thank you for supporting this work. Thank you for standing with us. As developers, condominium owners, rich folks want homeless people out of sight, out of mind, will spend $160,000 to try to stop us. So Vaughn, your mother stays here, your brother, your sister, you. What would you say to that man if you had a chance to talk to him, that man that's determined to just keep raising money and shutting us down?
Well, first off, it's not right, first and foremost. Like $160, like you said.
$160,000.
Yeah, right. $160,000, like you say. Like, you can open up something else to help a lot of people. Like, I see a lot of women and kids.
He's doing a crowdfunding thing to try to raise more money to stop us, okay? Right. I mean, wow, we need to pray, because these are wicked times. So, Vaughn, how is it making a difference in your life by being here at New Life Evangelistic Center?
Well, he's not good to be homeless, first and foremost, but mm-hmm. at the same time, it's been a good experience. Like, I learned to get humble and appreciate everything, because growing up, I just was ungrateful and just didn't appreciate nothing.
So it's helping you to be a grateful human being?
Right.
Making humble. A man out of you?
Right.
Oh, man. I mean, there's a lot of conditions out there can wear a guy down, make a guy bitter, make him angry and frustrated. Right. How old are you?
20.
So you're, and it's tough. You're moving to this transition. I mean, here you are, right. Expecting things out of you, right?
Mm-hmm.
You think you'll be able to learn some things here?
Yeah, I will learn a lot.
And what are your goals, dreams, and plans for the future?
Well, I want to become a film writer, director, mm-hmm. and entrepreneur. I want to open my own shelter, because I just want to help women and kids, like, and the pregnant women and a lot of handicaps on the street. As well, and just said,
even if you had the money, though, everybody says, not in my backyard. That's why we have to fight. There's no other place for people to go. We got to either fight it out here or leave them out on the streets. So that's the problem we have in this culture today. People are closing their hearts and minds to so many that are in need. And individuals, they come here, they get involved in a transitional housing program, a 30-day program, and they experience Jesus, and they experience a purpose. They experience an opportunity to make a difference for good. Individuals like Steve, and we're going to go back to Chrissy and talk to Steve, and they talk about that, and they want to continue on because God is doing something in their lives because of those of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center.
Stephen, you've come to New Life Evangelistic Center, and you've been in our 30-day program, last 30 days. How has being here benefited you toward your long-term goals in your life?
Well, it benefited me a lot, because I'm keeping positive attitude, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I'm working, mm-hmm. you know. I'm doing what I'm supposed to do here for working my little hour.
Mm-hmm.
But it's helping me a lot.
And you said you're looking for employment, or you're actually employed?
No, I'm already employed.
Okay.
Yeah, where, I'm working at Hershey. Without,
you don't have to give the name, but where are you working? Or if you want to.
Yeah, Hershey, a candy company.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do they have you doing?
Unloading boxes, putting the candy on the table.
Okay, good. But it's
yeah, motivating me.
No it's kidding. Motivating yeah. you, and you're able to save up money.
That's
and what do you want to do with the next 30 days? You've come in and you've completed 30 days. You're looking to do another 30 days. What's your plan after that time?
You know, Larry, I just hope everything goes right. I'm trying to get back with my girl, you know, mm-hmm. if that's possible. You know? But I don't know, you know. I might just go and get my own apartment if that's...
So it sounds like you're still seeking direction for your life,
yeah,
right?
That's what I'm doing.
And so how has being in this environment where we pray and we read the scriptures together, how has that helped you in finding direction for your life?
Yeah, I mean, a lot. You know, I grew up going to church, Larry. Mm-hmm. I grew up going to church. You know, and since I've been here, you know, it helped me a lot.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I pray every night, you know, try to do the right thing, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm just thankful that I got a roof in my head right now.
What are some of the things that you've done here to help other people?
For the brothers, I helped a lot of brothers here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, giving them good advice.
You work the door, so you help with security here.
Security,
you
help to keep. I help a lot of that.
We got you involved in cleaning here too, so you're picking up and helping keep the dorm clean upstairs too. Yep. Well, we just thank God for Stephen, and we thank God for this opportunity to be there for one another. And I just want to invite you to pray for the work at this time, to pray for Stephen as he's seeking God's direction in his life. But also just want to ask you to lift up the ministry's financial needs at this time.
That's what we all want, is to get closer to God and get His ongoing direction for our lives, to let His light and love flow through us, and we get that direction and we pursue it. We may encounter obstacles. Savon, you follow through on what God has laid on your heart to do, you're going to encounter obstacles. And that's why at this time, use this time to just draw close to the Lord Jesus, learn everything you can about Him, and just get into the Word of God and read the Word over and over until it gets down deep inside of you.
Right.
Yeah. The Psalms are great to read through the Psalms, read through the Gospel of John. I mean, it's all good stuff. Wow. I mean, the whole Bible's got so much stuff in it. Ephesians, I mean, Colossians, Romans. I mean, I can just mention book after book, Hebrews, book of James. I mean, Old Testament, New Testament. That's why I have to read through it at least once a year. There's so much in it. Right. Got any special verses yourself?
To be honest, no, I'm still trying to get...
Still just getting into it, is it?
Yeah.
You feel like God's using all this to draw you closer to Him?
Right. Well, of course, yeah.
Well, what about that day when your mama got the word, is your mother and also your aunt at the same time, that you guys got to move from here? And mama's on the phone calling over and over this hotline, and they're just telling her they don't have no place for her, didn't they? Remember that when Mama was making those calls?
Yeah. That was sad.
What?
It was sad.
It was, wasn't it?
Right.
And then time came and they started grabbing your stuff. I think they even put handcuffs on your aunt when they put her out or something, is what she was telling her story.
Yeah. Oh, right. Yeah, there was.
Oh, yeah. Wow, it's hard. I mean, sometimes people are pretty cold, too, in the process of putting them out in it.
I mean, it's just like going through this, it lets you see, like, who with you and who not, like, who for you. Like, it's a lot of people. Like they claim they love and care about you, and then at the same time, like they can turn your back on you. And when it comes down to helping somebody, that's when they freeze up and don't know what they do.
It's hard for you. You're kind of like man of the family, and see this happen to your mama and your sister and the rest. Right. Did you do some praying?
A lot.
Did you? Are you seeing God's answers to prayers as you're praying like this? That you're starting to see it. Just got to be patient.
Right.
And just be patient. I mean, you try to take matters in our own hands. There's Moses. He tried to redeem the nation of Israel in his own hand, killed an Egyptian. He's 40 years of age. He had to go into the wilderness for 40 years to get all that self-sufficiency out of him. And then God calls him and God uses him as a great deliverer. Okay, so now you've gone through some stuff the last few months. God's showing you that you got to depend on Him, is He?
All right.
Yes, and He may be doing the same thing to you. He's done it to me. He continues to go through this breaking process. Say, Lord, I need You. And then we start to see Him move in a special way, in a powerful way. We're serving a mighty, mighty God. I want to encourage you, brothers and sisters, to be a part of the miracles that God is doing at this particular time. Yep. We got this group out here, this developer trying to raise more money after he spent $160,000 trying to stop us from doing the work of God. We need your help at this particular time. We need your prayers here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Scheduled for trial November the 9th. We need a financial miracle. And you can be a part of the blessing of giving people a second chance, giving people a hand up, not a handout, an opportunity to learn, to grow, to experience the fact that Christ loves them and has a plan for their life. Your gift goes so far at New Life Evangelistic Center. Because of our dedicated staff and trainees and volunteers, every dollar you share provides $3 worth of direct help. And we do need your help at this time. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Thank you for helping New Life to be there when people are hurting. Thank you for standing with us at this critical hour. Thank you for all that you're doing and for all of your prayers.